Hey, guess who's here? It's me, the Damey. That never happens anymore. No, I'm kidding. I feel like it just feels like it's been a mega long time because I was like gone, and I was like gone again for a long time. I only streamed like once, and that makes me feel like it's a million. But Damey, my lovely Damey, it's me. It's the Damey. Here now. Oh, I have class registration tomorrow, so I'm freaking out. You turn down the music, it's too loud. I got you. I can also turn on my mic a little bit. The issue is that when I turn on my mic, then the Pharaoh's curse gets also louder. I sound like I'm on Dollar Tree mic. Maybe I am on Dollar. No, that it should be this. It might just be my voice is not like good right now. It's okay. yeah, the Pharaoh's curse is still. I need to R&D this mic. Not R&D. RMA. That's the one. R&D. I need to design a new mic, actually. No, I don't care that much. You thought I was playing Dameycraft? No, I was not playing Dameycraft. I'm sorry. Although I do wanna, you know what? That's actually real and based. I've been thinking about it. I kinda wanna play Oxygen Not Included on stream before I play Dameycraft again. Because I really like Oxygen Not Included. It's a good game. I want a game more because I have now I have a little bit of time before the quarter ends. I'm not doing this today. This is just here. But yeah, I have a bit of time now that I don't have to like do stuff every night, which is great. I don't know, I think next quarter should, I don't know how it's gonna be. The schedule that I have, I think is gonna be pretty decent for streaming, but like, I don't know how much work it is because the fluids class that I'm trying to take, fluid dynamics, apparently the professor is like, you know what? We had to put the chicken standing directly on the tablet. Jesus Christ! Why are you doing it so much? We got some hieroglyph posters in chat. Also, wait, I'm trying to, my astigmatism. Wait, do you go by Ma-Q or like Ma-Qs? Or should I just call you Maybe? Because I was gonna say Maybe, and then I was like, that seems like a weird way of referring to somebody. Alright, I'm just grabbing some problems. Oh no, we have to do math. No, my least favorite thing. Oh, you guys missed my comeback era in Dynamics. I was cooking. I mean, I still am cooking, but I was on top of this, but now we're gonna go back to shit. Okay. So this is, what is it? Newton's second law of rotation and transformation. So FMA with rigid bodies is the dynamics. It's pretty much the same as particles, except that it's like if you have a bunch of particles. Who would have thought? So instead of saying like sum of F equals MA, which is what we have for particles, we have sum of F. We also have sum of the moments, which are just forces at a distance that can cause things to rotate, equals I bar alpha. And I bar is the mass moment of inertia, and alpha is our angular acceleration. Mass moment of inertia is kind of goofy. It's also, ironically, the only thing that's ever broken me in engineering were moments of inertia. Basically, what a moment of inertia is it says, depending on the shape of the object, so maybe you have like a beam that sort of looks like this. Depending on the shape of the object, it's gonna like, perform differently in whatever you may be doing. Like if you're trying to rotate this around a certain thing versus if you're trying to rotate, like a cylinder, that's different. But the way you do it is by basically just doing a bunch of calculations of numbers and adding them all up in a very specific way. And if you get one of them wrong, then you're screwed. And there's like you have to do like 50 calculations. So I don't like doing them because computers can do them, and the computer can do it much more correctly than I can. But anyway, yeah, it has to deal with rotation. It can also deal with if you're trying to find like a centroidal axis, which is like where an object will be in equilibrium if you're trying to like balance it on something. That's also what you can use a moment of inertia processes for, or the moment of inertia requires the centroid. So, all right, let's see. So two pendulums, A and B, mass and inertia released from rest, which has the larger mass moment of an I blew in the port, so maybe that's what it was. I'm gonna pretend like it's dust. Like, not dust. I wonder what it is. I'm not an electrical engineer by any means, but I really do wonder what it is. Wonder if it's like some ultra like conductive noise thing. Because it's weird to me that it happens, so often, and it doesn't seem to happen based off of anything that I have that's producing noise. Anyway, when we're trying to find, oops, that was my phone. When we're trying to find a total moment of inertia, if we have a bunch of different shapes, like let's say we have, oh, I don't know, like a hammer, an upside down hammer. What we can do is moment of inertias, or these mass moments of inertias are taken by integrals of basically saying like mass over the area, something like that. So we tend to know a general formula for each shape. Like we'll know the I bar for what this is on its own, and we know the I-bar for what this is on its own. So what we tend to do is, like a problem like this, if we want to say the total I-bar, is we say that it equals the I of the ball plus the distance squared times the mass. So this distance is how far it is away from like the pivot point that we're trying to rotate. So the farther it is away, the more inertia it's going to have, the more like rotatey it's going to be. So in this case, I think that we have to look up the mass moment of inertia of a sphere. So let's say mass moment of inertia sphere 2/5 mr squared. So we have 2/5 mr squared. We're gonna assume that radius is the same for both of them. And this first one is, we'll do this one first because I put in m. So first one is l squared times m. That's for one. And then for two, or for, sorry, for b. Let's call it b because it's b. And then for a, we have 2/5 times 2 mr squared plus L over 2 times 2m. So this will cancel and this will cancel. Nope, I lied. L over 2 squared times 2m. So we can... what might be the best way to do this? So this is going to be 4. Let me do this. 4/5 mr squared plus L squared over 2. And this one is 2/5 plus L squared. So B is gonna be the bigger moment of inertia because this one is like a smaller fraction and this is also a smaller fraction and everything else is the same. So B. The point of this one, I think, is to say that because there's a squared in the distance, it's not just gonna instantly cancel out the fact that it's closer, right? The distance is more meaningful than the mass. The farther away it is, the more impactful that's going to be. So that makes sense. That's good. Okay, same. There's a continuation of this question. Let's see. I will put it on a different page just because they asked me to, but I kind of want to put it on the same page. And then we can just reference. Let's put it on the same page. Let's be crazy. Let's be wild. You know? They told me to put it on different pages, but I'm gonna put it on the same page. It's like the same problem. Okay, so we have to figure out which has a larger angular acceleration immediately after release. So, alright, the sum of the moments is gonna equal I bar alpha. And, okay. So, for this one, what this is saying is that we're treating, so when I say this, this I bar is going to be the I bar for this and this as one big object. The other way you can do that is instead of saying it like this, like I bar alpha, you can treat this mass as its own mass, like moving, and then we can say that it's constrained to this point, and we can basically set up the parallel axis theorem within our moment equation, instead of having to do an actual mass moment of inertia, which, you know, when you have a lot more shapes, for this one it doesn't really matter, right, because it's like a known thing and we know it, and it's not that hard to do, but it's definitely times when you don't want to have to do that. So let's see, maybe we can do it like that. Good morning. Let me grab my book. Oh, it's in the page. I had my exam in dynamics, and I was like, there's not gonna be a homework due Monday. And I went and did some, you know, project stuff, and I didn't think about like work stuff, and then I looked at my calendar and it said, this is due Monday, and then I went, oops, oh well. It was a very boring exam, which is sort of not super fun, because dynamics is usually not boring. Usually it's kind of fun. It was pretty boring. It was, okay, get this. I was a little mad. It was like a linkage problem. And so there was like a semicircular thing that was getting pulled up. And there was a point on that which like went over here and then went over here. Like this. And you had to find the acceleration of like of this. And it was just like you had to find the omega of this, and then you had to find the omega of this, and then you had to find the omega of this, and then you had to find the angular acceleration of this, and the angular acceleration of this, and it was like six steps, and like you had to set them equal to, because you had to do, to find the angular acceleration of this, you had to relate this to this, and so then you had to find this to this. It was like, it wasn't hard, it was just really boring. Like it was not, it was just a lot of calculations, which is, I feel like, because if I was giving a problem, okay, if I was giving a problem, there's one problem that, like, if we hadn't done it, I probably would have given something like this. It was, how do you draw it? It's like this, and this, and then this, and this. And so there's sort of like a pin here that this can rotate about. And then there's a pin here. And then like, it's like an oil rig. I don't remember if we did this one or not. But this is great because one of the things you can test is whether people notice that this is a member that only translates. Because if this is moving in a circle this way, the velocity here is going up. And if this is moving in a circle, the velocity here is going up. And so this member doesn't rotate at all, it's just when you go up, it's gonna translate, you know, in space, not rotate. And so then that would be like a lot less calculation, because you only have to do like this part of the problem. But you could catch people who don't understand this and have them have to do like, you know, the equivalent of like the longer problem that we were given. Because there were no like non-rotating members, which was, you know, it's whatever. Okay, so the way that we would say this without doing, like if we want to use, so this is for like, I bar like total. But if we want to do the other one, the other way, we say the sum of the moments about, let's just call this O. Sum of the moments about O equals I bar alpha. Plus R of, we'll just call it M, or B with respect to O, cross MBG. And so that's how we could do this if we weren't, if we didn't want to use the parallel axis theorem. Because if we draw like the free body diagram for this, so like this, we have, you know, an MG pulling us down. And then if we draw the kinetic diagram, we're gonna have an acceleration downward and, you know, an angular acceleration. And so if we take the moment about here and we don't have this as a full thing, then we have to just say that, oh, there's a perpendicular distance in between here, and we have to account for this acceleration instead of, you know, treating it as one big thing. I guess this is sort of like a dotted line. It's kind of a free body. Anyway, that is not relevant to this because we have one where I of B is greater than I of A, which means that, so if our moments are the same, are our moments the same? No, our moments aren't going to be the same, because we have a longer length. So some of the moments would be, I don't know, what is it? 90 minus theta for our angle here. Or, I mean, I guess we could just say this way. Because what do we want? We want this distance. So it's gonna be, tilting my head, sine theta times L over 2 times mg. Well, this is gonna be times 2m. That's our thing. This is gonna be negative, doesn't really matter. And then we have this IA and the angular acceleration. So it's sort of over IA. And I'm not adding this because we're, you know, taking the moment about the full. We're using the IA, not the other thing. And then for the other one, we'll have negative sine theta times L times mg over IB. So these are the same. And then we just say that, well, we said IB is bigger, so IA is smaller, so it's bigger. Which, you know, kind of makes sense. This has like a farther distance to travel, so it's not... The acceleration is sort of spread out more, versus this one is kind of all clumped together, so you're not going to see as much. This one is going to be able to move faster through an angle than this one is, so... So A. Cool. That seems about right. Let's see. What else have we got? Ah! Cylinders, wheels, we love that. We love wheels. Wheels were the bane of my existence. You know, it's actually super interesting though. I will say, thinking about wheels is, they are very unintuitive. Which is kind of fun to mess around with in like real life and see what they do. And be amazed and realize you understand nothing about the way that forces actually go sometimes. Alright, so we have two solid cylinders, they have the same mass. Okay, that's good to know. Each is accelerated from rest with a force. In order to impart identical angular accelerations, what is the relationship between F1 and F2? Alright, so we want some of the moments about the center. I'll just call both these a center. Center point equals I bar A plus I bar A. So all right, these are solid cylinders, so we need to grab the mass moment of inertia of a solid cylinder. And we're talking about the middle, so we're kind of chomping. 1/2 mr squared. 1/2 m times 2r squared. So this is going to be about like ratios. Alpha a. I'm going to just solve for alpha a real quick. Alpha a equals 1/2. Nope. Equals, let's do the moment. So in this case, the moment's going to be, negative, so negative F1 times 2R. That's going to be divided by 1/2 M2R squared. Yeah. Let's see. I think the idea is we have, you know, the moments are different here, but also their moments of inertia are different, so we'll see how much that affects it. I'm just going to jump straight to B because it's not that different. So F2 times R over 1 half m r squared. So obviously this and this cancel out, and this and that cancel out. And if we set these equal to each other, we get F1 over, I'm gonna say 2R equals F2 over R. Wait, cancel the R's. 1 equals 2F2. Which, again, that sort of makes sense. We have to put in more force to get a bigger thing moving faster. Which we like. We like that. If F2 was smaller, or if F2 was bigger, that might be an issue, because it's little, and it's not gonna take as much force to accelerate. It's kind of cool that these cancel out like this, though, for cylinders. That you end up with, like, just over the radius. The angular acceleration. Although, I feel like that also sort of makes sense. It's like the radius is directly proportional to the angular acceleration. I'm gonna probably talk about it in my super overview of Dynamics, my speedrun, but angular acceleration is, or acceleration in general, the angular component of it, like you have like your angular acceleration, your tangential acceleration times with your radius, like let's say AC. And you have your normal, which is minus RAC. So, yeah, it makes sense that it would be dependent on the radius, because the radius is right there. It's in the thing. Cool. All right, now let's get to an actual problem. Oh god, I'm so worried. Okay. Oh god, it's like so. Okay, it's gonna be a little pixelated. It's like a Mario level. You know when you go to the Mario level and there's always one that's pixelated? That's really specific. I don't know why that's the first thing that came to my mind. Alright. Completely filled barrel and its contents have a combined mass of 90 kilograms. Metric. Okay. Cylinder C is connected to the barrel at a height of whatever. Oh no, no, the barrel will not tip. Oh god, okay. That's great for me. Okay. So we have to figure out. The barrel will not tip. That means that the barrel's not going to rotate, is what that means. So, will not tip. This means that angular acceleration equals zero. Sum of moments equals zero. Like a statics problem. But then we also have to say that, we have to make sure that, like, it may or may not be moving. But we want the maximum mass, so it's probably going to be moving. I don't know. We'll have to see. Alright, where do we start? Let's do... Let's do a free body diagram. How about that? That seems like a good place to start. So this is an F equals MA. It's free body. Make it a little bigger than that. Beautiful, beautiful barrel. I was gonna say barrel G, but G is usually just used for centroid, so we can't call them barrel G. What should we call barrel? We're gonna be working with the barrel for a while. I'm gonna call them. This is a weird naming convention. I'm not sure why they did that. So I guess I can't call it B. I'm gonna call it Daryl. Daryl the barrel. Alright, Oh, they didn't give 5. Okay, weird. So there's a force that's gonna be pulling this way. Of our tension. Then we've got a weight force. We got kilogram soldium G. We got a normal force down at the bottom, which we're gonna need actually for our frictions. And then we're gonna. Daryl is not gonna pull himself forward, so. Let's call the barrel. What the heck? I cannot read that. Let's call the barrel broken paperclip? How do you pronounce that? This is our friction point. Let's call the barrel that. I don't know what that is. Okay, our FBD. Freaking big Daryl. That's what FBD stands for. And then here's our KD. This is gonna be the way that we accelerate. D, I guess. I'm gonna call this D. MD. AD. And we want to say I bar alpha 0. Alright, that gives us some stuff to work with. Whoa! Damie stream. Yeah, it's me! It's Damie! I'm here! It's crazy, I know, right? It's almost like I'm a streamer or something. I don't do that often. I'm getting back into it. My voice is still a little goofy, if you couldn't tell. And now he's using Linux. Oh, hey. That's awesome. MCAC. I have to be a little bit more careful with my subscripts, because now we have multiple dudes running around here. But our massive C is like, nothing else is an unknown that's a mass at least. So let's pull some stuff here. Let's do some of the forces in Y. I like that. Technically that should be negative. Or should it? No, it shouldn't. Whatever. Critical processes end expectantly. Plasma KDE. The whole plasma KDE just died. What is that? I don't know what that is. MCG equals MCAC. So T equals MCAC plus MCG. I'm just gonna make this a little cleaner. AC plus G. Like that? We're good with that? Yeah. Okay. It's the desktop environment. Oh no. Wait. Windows Explorer? Wait, like File Explorer? Or like. Desktop environment is, the one that looks like a file? Oh, okay. That's not that bad. You just, like, restart your text, your taskbar or whatever. Oh boy. Okay, now I have to do some different sums here. So let's do some of the forces in X first. Sorry, some of the forces in Y. Equals, sorry. M, D, A, Y, which is 0. So that means that mg equals n. Mdg equals n. Because we'll need that for our friction forces. Now, we have to kind of figure out what friction is going to happen. But we'll figure that out. It doesn't matter too much as long as... I think it's going to move, so... But, doesn't really matter too much, as long as we, you know, because we, the idea is that our friction force is usually, like, a coefficient times the normal force, right? So it just matters what coefficient we're putting in there, it doesn't really matter, which case. The only case that, you know, is an issue is if it's less than this, and then, yeah, just restart the PC, oh, true. If it's less than the if I'm pushing on something and it's not a lot of force, the friction force is gonna be like, you know, matching my force. But other than that, don't forget to account for air resistance. Oh god, no. Please god, no, that's my fluids class probably. I want to be excited about fluids and stuff, because, like, I don't know if it's common Dany lore, but, like, one of my favorite things is, like, water. And, like, like the physical sort of properties of water. And it's very exciting to me. And I really don't want a class here that's, like, just taught poorly to, you know, ruin that. So. Okay, so I can set these T's equal to each other. Now, John and Friday? Oh, I can do that. I can drink. I actually have some drinkos here. That was good. I'm gonna have to do some moments, I think. I see. That is interesting. Okay.
Just remove the. I have a water?
Oh, yeah. I've had a water. I just don't bring it out. I only bring it out for Drown Friday. Water jump scare. New moments about. Like right here. I don't know what I'm gonna call this. This is like, oh. Oh no, wait a second. But like, it might not be. Okay. Water level detection when? Okay, that was like the first project I ever wanted to do. Like, that was the. I had a whole thing I was gonna do. I don't know if I'm ever gonna make it, but. And that could happen. Okay, I think. If it's tipping, the normal force is gonna be like here. So I'm gonna say that it. Oh wait, I don't have any perpendicular distances. What if I say that it's right on the corner? Does that make sense? Is that a 2D model? what? Yeah, the water? Yes. I wanna have a 3D model at some point though. I'm just gonna say that it tips. I'm gonna say that it does. I'm gonna do a evil sin and I'm gonna say that it tips here and we're gonna figure it out if it doesn't do that. Cause then I know the perpendicular distances. I mean, I'm gonna take the thing about this point anyway, but that like is logical to me. Okay, so we're gonna take the moment about whatever this donkus point is. I'm gonna call it triangle. If someone made your model in Blender and it looked like that, they deserve a prize. I could do it. Well, I'm gonna be making my model in Blender probably. It wouldn't look exactly like this. I think I would actually go with a different design choice. Like a different style it's positive, that one's a negative, sorry. Than my whatchamacallit, my duder. My 2D. It'd be pretty difficult. You could do it with like grease pencil. I'm probably gonna use grease pencil when I make my 3D model, because I think it looks cool. You could do it. I mean, the thing that it would just be the nose would be hard, I think, to do. I don't know how to like block that. You know? Ooh, okay, this is interesting. So if there's no moment, then we know what the tension is. But see, the thing is that like I guess then I can find AD. Oh, because I don't know AC. think of making a cosplay, but it'd be too difficult. Oh, Bridget. Yeah, that's not difficult. Just go get a yo-yo. And the maximum mass so the barrel won't tip. Ugh. Okay, wait, no, I think I'm getting there. I think this is in the right direction, but how do I get AC? constraint equation. I can't believe I forgot about that. That's good. Yes, because then I have AD, and then, okay, good, good. Okay, we're winning. I need my calculator. Gravity defying handcuff? Wait, does Bridget have that? I think of like the nun hoodie. Does that make sense? I don't know if I'm just making stuff up. Hello? Mr. Calculator? Wait, why is this? What? Oh, here it is. The redesign. Oh wait, there's a redesign? Wait, pull up. Computer. Pull up Bridget image. Okay, what's M? I forgot. Like 90 something? A lot. Yeah, sure. Okay. 90 times 0.25 times 9.8. Oh, this is gonna give us a big number. I guess it's a really big barrel though, so let's see. Four hundred point nine. Okay, that seems like a fairly good number to get. Alright, so then we have that, and then we need AD. So we say 400.9. I need axes. I'm the kind of guy that'd be like, wake up in the middle of the night, screaming out bed, I need axes. I forgot axes on my free body diagram. Please don't hurt me. I'm so bad about putting axes on. It's not because I don't like them. I just forget. Okay, now we need to figure out what the mu is. If we're saying that it accelerates, is it accelerating from rest? Okay, we're gonna say that it's kinetic, okay? Just between you and me. Okay? We're gonna say that it's kinetic, and we're gonna see if that's right. Might not be right. 0.35 times our normal force, which is gonna be the same as our mass. 90 times 9.8. I'm just plugging stuff into this equation, by the way. Plus 90 times AD. Okay, I'm loving it. What's AD gonna equal? This is exciting. This is great for us. Because I think they just equal each other. The accelerations are the same. The 400.9 minus 0.35 times 90 times 9.8. 90.2, and this divided by 90. 1.024. 1.025 meters per second squared. Okay, lovely. I'm ecstatic. You can't tell. Okay, we need a constraints equation. I'm gonna put it like here, I guess. So we say that L equals, this is XC. This is XD. Oh my gosh, it's a face. Daryl the barrel. Okay. XD plus XC. So we say that VD plus VC equals zero. And then AD plus AC equals zero. I sent you the Bridget I want to cosplay. Oh, let me see. Oog! Okay, we're getting there, I'm running over. Is this an acceptable form of ref sheet, or should I do that? Wait, that's so cool. I love that. I like that you put dimensions on it. Are they accurate dimensions? Wait, that's so cool. Wait, I would totally do an art fight, this version. Oh yeah, that's the one that I'm thinking about. Oh, she has a handcuff? I didn't realize she had a handcuff. Wait, what? Like a belt? That's so cool. Those dimensions all came from the depths of hell. I'll draw you, Oh, you know what? It's actually perfect because I didn't get the chance to do this last R fight. If you put them up for R fight, or maybe if we do like a trade or something. I really wanted to do like an engineering drawing of something. Like have it in SolidWorks and like actually model it out and like put it in the drawing. And I feel like your character would be great for that. AD equals negative AC. So that means when C goes down, A moves to the right. Vexel's on R5, but I haven't actually put Scribble on there. Now take your time, we got time. Okay, so then we say T, so 400.9 equals MC, which is... Oh wait, I need MC. Why can't I find what MC is? 1.025 plus 9.8. MC equals... Ironically, Vexel made Scribble, but Scribble was designed by... Islaw? Oh my god, my astigmatism. Maybe that is an I. I can't read that very well. The 400 divided by this plus 9.8. 37. 37.04. Isla. Oh. Yeah, that would make sense. 0.04 kilograms. Is it right? I don't know. Who knows? It's probably gonna be wrong. But that's okay if it's wrong. We'll just keep going. Yeah, it's wrong. 195.9. If I had to guess, it's probably because of this moment that I took. This moment about this point. It's probably not necessarily that point. If I had to guess. But that's kind of how dynamics problems are. You get them wrong on the first time, and that's okay. And then you have to like figure out what you did, and then you're like, oh, it wasn't actually that far off. Like I had like 90% of the way there. I love multiplying the numbers, looking at the result, and thinking, nah, that can't be right. But it was in fact right, and you did it wrong the second time. I'm not a second timer very much when I do exams, which is maybe bad, but I just kind of go, yeah, this is gonna be right. And then if it's wrong, it's like, the reason I got it wrong was probably not because of any fundamental, conceptual understanding, unless it is my CE class, because I did just not go to lectures or something. But it's probably just because I like did some math wrong. I got 33 divided by 80. Wait, 33 out of 80? That's okay. I got... what is that? Yeah, that's probably a little lower than what I got, but like, I got some... Oh, you skip stuff. Oh, I never skip stuff. I try not to skip stuff. Oh boy. Bars A, B, and B, E. Ugh. Moment of inertia. It's okay, we can do the thing I was talking about before where we have like the two and then we just take their parallaxis theorem distances in the moment equation. Know that the assembly is released from rest in the position shown. And neglecting the masses of the links, determine the acceleration of the assembly and the forces in the links. Okay. Acceleration in the assembly, that's going to be a kinematics problem. So we got to do that first. Which is unfortunate because it's probably going to take a little bit of time. Let's see. First off, let's say what we know. Well, we know that this is going to move in a circle on B, and this is going to move in a circle on C. So as this swings down, this member... Wait. No. If it were just the top part, that would be a member that's not rotating. But we have the second, we have a thing out here, and that's gonna make our lives hell. I hate dividing by multiple digit numbers and decimals. I was never taught how to do it and never will. The bus stop method? Wait, wait, what? Multiple, like, are you talking about like long division? Like, this thing? Can I even do this anymore? Like two? I don't even know if I can do this anymore. 34, wait, 6, 20, 36, 30, 5. Is that right? This is like not right. Minus 30. It's 4, 4 sixths. Is that. That's not gonna be right, right? Oh, it is right. I don't know how I did that. I didn't think about that at all. I have not done long division in so many years. That's... I was thinking about it like polynomial division. Ugh, weird. I was always taught to do that. Realistically, you're never gonna need to do that in your life. Like, I mean, you need to know how to do it when you're like learning it for the first time, but like, you're always gonna use a calculator to divide big numbers. Like, I don't do anything by hand. That would take me so much extra time and I would get it wrong and then it wouldn't be good. Okay, I want the acceleration of the assembly. Oh, the angular acceleration. Wait, the angular acceleration assembly or just the jump? Oh no, I have to do the... Okay, I have to do the downward and the... Oh, gamers, it's so over. Okay, wait, maybe we don't do this one. I actually don't know if... This one feels a little weird. Okay, maybe we try this one. This one... Oh, God. These just keep getting more and more like saw traps. Look at this thing. What is this thing? I think it's kind of funny, actually. That's a creature. It's like two eyes and a beak. Oh my god, wait, if you turn it like this. Wait, if you turn it like this and you look at like these as the eyes, like it's like looking disapprovingly. Like that, and like this is the mouth. Or it looks like a smug anime girl, like I'm laughing at you. Tee hee hee. What do I need to calculate? 175 divided by pi, 2 pi? Never. You never need to do that. That's also not a good number to do any calculations with. I do pi times 1600 divided by 172. I will say, like, if I was gonna do that, it's like you do 172 divided by 2. Just start, like, taking out, like, well, like, do pi last. But, like, you just start taking out chunks. So, like, oh, 1600 sucks, but, like, if we say 530, or not 530, 800 divided by, let's see, 172 would be 50 plus 35 plus 1. 50, 35, 1 is, like, 90. 96? And then, you know, you can take out another 2. I just do that. It's a lot faster for me. Like, if I have to do something by hand, I'm not gonna, like, actually... What are you gonna do dividing that? It's basically just dividing it. Yeah, tau times that? Yeah. That doesn't really help you as much. Okay, triangular weldment is guided by two pins that slide freely in parallel curved slots of radius 6 inches in a vertical plate. It weighs 16 pounds, the center mass is located at G. Thank God it gave me center mass. Knowing that the instant shown, the velocity of each pin. is downward along the slots. Oh, I like that. So VB. VA. Okay, this one we can do a little easier, I think. I think this is a better, Oh, I see, so we need the acceleration of the weldment, and then we can use F equals MA so we can find the forces, because we'll back out the forces. Okay. Okay. Okay, I'm cool with that. So we need to find the acceleration. I had to find out how many 172 length curvy segments it would take to make a funny circle diameter of 16. See, that's a weird question. Well, I guess it's not that weird. You might use that in your life sometime. What's it doing? Oh, angular acceleration. Okay, it's a rigid body. So the angular the angular acceleration is anything. I might as well just do the angular acceleration at like G. Or do I need the acceleration too? Like, it's not only that, right? I can't do some of the moments because I can't. No. No. I got two sizes. Morally questioned a bit, lengthened unit only used in this message. Let's maybe just start relating things that we know. So VA equals VB plus V. No, that's not gonna be good. Okay, fine. VG plus VA with respect to G. Which we're saying that if a body is translating and it's turning, then we want to say that its velocity is the sum of those two. So we translate and we turn. And so it'll be like that. Yeah. Like that. So that's going to give us, what is this? VG. I don't know VG. But I do know VA, I guess. Well, what's stopping LGBTQ from being TQGLB? Nothing, I guess, but like, that's just the timeline we're in. Plus Omega, Omega, G. I'm gonna just pop it in the... I'm actually such a big fan of just popping in little matrices like this, because it's just so clean. I don't have to worry about it. A with respect to G, we're going negative 6, 3, 0. Look at that. Clean. What if it were a different timeline? Well, then maybe it would be that. This is too many unknowns is the issue. Because I don't know VG, and I also don't know omega G. But maybe the gods will shine upon me and we get a radius that cancels, but I don't think so. I think there's a trick that I have to know that I'm not knowing. In this case, we're going both negative, so negative 6, negative 6, 0. I mean, we do know the VA is going to be 0, negative 30, 0. And we know that this is also going to be 0, negative 30. Oh, I guess I could set them equal to each other, and the VGs will cancel out. Ooh. But then that's also not good because it's just gonna be this. I don't know why that's a bad thing actually. Wait, if the velocity of two points are the same, there's not gonna be angular. not gonna be angular acceleration. I mean, there's not gonna be angular rotation. Omega equals zero. Because not rotating. yet. But no one can read that. Write that better. Engineering lettering. There you go. I remember when you were doing math, I kind of understood. Now it's just words. It's, I would say, so the thing about dynamics is like, and the thing about physics in general is physics is actually a lot less math than you'd think. A lot of it is like relationships between things. So like, yeah, this is math, but really what I'm doing is I'm trying to figure out, I have a point A, like I have a bunch of stuff that they give me at the beginning, and I'm trying to get over here to the stuff that they want me to find. And I just have to pick the right order to get there. And there are rules about the order that I can take to get there. And stepping stones that I can use. But the math is more of like a tool. If that makes sense. So like this cross product, right? It's like, this is math for sure, but also this is kind of like just being able to divide two numbers. You know, it's just an operation that you're doing to something to find a specific thing about it. So yeah, dynamics is mostly words. I do understand. Pattern recognition. Yeah. An application. Exactly. Okay, I do need to try and figure out the angular acceleration at G though, which is... great. Great. Let's just maybe figure it out by doing this. Okay, we don't know the angular acceleration at A, and we don't know the angular acceleration at B. We don't really know anything. We know that our omega is zero, so there's not gonna be any... I just can't recognize the patterns, and I don't know what I can apply. Well yeah, that's part of learning. And obviously, like, I'm not... like, this is not me teaching dynamics, this is me, like, doing dynamics, you know? So, like, if I was teaching it, you would be able to see, like, for me, a lot of teaching math or physics or whatever is, like, giving people the patterns, like, telling them the patterns and showing them how to work with them. Some teachers or professors will, like, kind of... They won't really explicitly tell you, which is, you know, sometimes frustrating for people. Or I think that, not even just frustrating, it's just not great. I mean, like, there's no reason why you wouldn't want to just tell people stuff, you know? This is zero. Do I need to know why something works to know how it works? No, I'm telling you why it works will only make me hate math more because I get so overwhelmed. Well, that's what being an engineer is, the why it works. How it works is more like you can do that in anything, but engineers have to know why it works so that we can make other things work. This is okay. So, that means that G is also moving downward at this instant. I think. Maybe. But so I don't understand how we're gonna get... oh, never mind. Never mind. We're gonna do some... it's not kinematics. I'm silly. Math is a tool, then I'm not a toolsmith. I just use the tools they make. Well, yeah, I'm not a toolsmith either. I'm not a mathematician. That's not my, am I a math magician? Yes. I like to be a wizard of the maths and use them to, do things. But... that doesn't It depends on your area of study. In the math arts, so to speak. A counter? I don't know what that is. Okay, so we only have an MG. No, I lied. we have a reaction here. Oh, I see. I see. We're gonna have some sort of normal force here, at an angle. Oh, they give us the angle. Oh, we're chillin'. Oh, I don't actually have to worry about this as much. Okay, okay, okay. So this is a normal A. This is a normal B. I don't like drawing them like that. Why did I draw them like that? So, generally when you solve things with vectors in them, vectors have two parts, right? They have a direction in which they point, and they have a magnitude. And, you know, when I was thinking about solving this, I was like, dang, I'm gonna have four unknowns. Because these two, we don't know these reactions. This is the reaction at A, and this is the reaction at B, right? Like the thing pushing against evil mode. The reaction at A pushes against the pin as it slides through the slot. But they gave us an evil angle. So I don't have to find the evil angle, I only have to find the evil magnitude. Make my life a lot easier, that's only two unknowns. And so if I take a moment about one of these and I get rid of this, then I can actually take a moment to get an acceleration. Which is exciting. Because I thought I wasn't gonna- I literally thought I had to do kinematics. But, you know, it is an FMA problem set, so maybe I should have tried vector graphics. Not necessarily vector graphics per se. Do they give me an I bar? No. Evil Dynamics is hilarious. Yeah, I should be evil more often. I think that being evil is a great thing. I think that as wizards, you have to have an evil wizard, obviously. Oh my gosh, hey Storm, how's it going? Talking about evil dynamics wizards. Do vector graphics use vectors? Yes. Evil wizards are cool. Yeah, I feel like you should have to fight. Like you have like, oh my gosh, it's like Sonic, like the one game where they have like the hero path and the evil path. That's what you can do with dynamics. You can become an evil dynamics wizard, or you can become a good hero dynamics wizard. And the plot twist is that they're both the same, but like, you just have to solve problems that are like evil. Oh, that would be so funny. Where you have to solve problems like, you need to make a guillotine that cuts with this much force, you evil dynamics. And then in good dynamics, it's like, oh, I need to make a knife to cut a loaf of bread. Good, thanks, and you? I'm pretty good. What am I doing? We're working on some dynamics problems with mass moment of inertia and Newton's second law. Rotating in along with, it's like general plane motion. Required to become the warrior you're able to hear. I'm lurking now. Have a good lurk. I need to figure out where I want to sum moments about. I'm trying to find the acceleration. So I need to. Oh, wait! This comes from G. I'm gonna sum moments about G. Wait, that's not gonna help me that much, is it? Erg. Yeah, physics for sure, geez. If I sum moments about G. Wait, that gets rid of the MAY. Oh wait, no, I want alpha. I need the reaction forces. This is what I'm gonna do after I find alpha, I think. But I need some more information. I don't have enough information. I need to find... What is the question? So this is the setup. It's a triangular sort of plate that's pinned into these two slots, and so it can move freely in these two slots here. And we're looking for the angular acceleration, and we're looking for the reactions. I'm trying to figure out, because we need alpha. Oh, okay. Need alpha, and there are a couple ways you can find it. But when I was doing the other way, I don't think we have, because generally, when you're doing like kinematic stuff, not in my knowledge. Oh, that's okay. Wait, Storm. I'm trying to get into my linear two class. I'm trying to take that my differential equations. So next quarter, it's looking good. It looks like there might be seats actually. I might be able to get in. We might be doing some more math around here. I'm very excited about that. How far along in university are you now? I am in my second year, my second quarter. So I have one more quarter left. We have four quarters, but like one quarter is summer. So I don't take classes in the summer. If you want to do math instead of physics, I could do something. No, I gotta do physics, unfortunately. I like doing physics. Yeah, I'm not a math major, so, but I want to take a math minor. It's just gonna be like my senior year, I think. I don't have time to take it before. I gotta get my prereqs out of the way. This is what we're gonna do after. How do I get that alpha? Generally, when we find alphas in kinematics problems, we want to find a point that's like not moving and then relate stuff to that. But we don't have that here because everything is moving. Let me see. What did we do? I wrote chapter one of my thesis? Oh my gosh, wait, congratulations. Teacher corrected and there's red everywhere. Aw. That's always hard, yeah. But that's awesome that you started writing it. That's great. Maybe I need to do moment equation. What were we trying to find there? We were trying to find alpha. We took a moment about O, which was one of our reactions. I mean, I guess I could take a moment about AB. Is that kosher? Not really, because you can change some commas? Oh no. That's scuff. That's hard. If I take a moment about AB, then the force G is, not gonna act on that. Oh! Wait, then only I bar alpha exists. Because it's a moment. Oh shit. Wait. Me when I'm like, oh, the acceleration didn't exist, but it's a moment. That's what I want though. Wait a second. Like, come back here, come back up there. I think the moment about AB, it's gonna equal I bar alpha. I've been in group theory. I do not agree with him, but I do not know if English people learn something different than French in group theory. I have not done group theory. I would hazard a guess though that they probably teach it differently. What kind of stuff was he like disagreeing with you on? I find the I bar of this. Do I actually have to do an I bar thing? I'm gonna cry if I have to do an I bar thing. This is gonna equal, it's literally just gonna equal I bar alpha. But wait, is that, I don't know what it equals. It equals I bar alpha, but that's just I bar alpha equals I bar alpha. Oh, god damn it. MZ is a cyclic group, and Z is a monogenous group. cyclic equals monotonous and finite. Maybe I would, if you can, like, search around the internet. Or maybe, do you have, like, an American... If you can find, like, an American, group theory textbook. That might help. I don't want to do this, though. This is pissing me off. I feel like I just don't know... I feel like I have too many unknowns, and I'm, like, not helping myself out here. Let me see about this. So, we say M-A-N and M-A-T for, like, a rotating thing. So, this is incorrect. But... I mean, I guess we can just say M-A-Y and M-A-X. It's not but it's like not rotating. Monogamy, so based. There's also English people saying cyclic for Z, but I think they do the error without knowing, just as a habit. Do they do it in papers and stuff? Or is it like... Let me see if I can... So Z, what is it? Group theory. Z. The Z is a finite group whose silo subgroups are all cyclic. That is what Wikipedia says. And you're saying it's a monogenous group. Let's see. Is it homogeneous? Maybe that's what... Yeah, maybe it's homogeneous. Homogeneous space for group G is a non-empty manifold of topological space X on which G acts transitively. Is that... I don't know if that helps at all. That sounds like a lot of words. What am I going to put on? What's some, like, fun, bouncy music? Oh, let's do Chula. This is making me insane. I feel like I don't have enough information to do this. Unless it's like, okay, so there's no omega. But if I could find the alpha through kinematics, then I wouldn't be having this issue. But if I have to find the alpha through kinematics, I need to know the alpha somewhere on it to relate to the other stuff. I guess I could do the angular acceleration. Maybe the angular acceleration of AB is fixed. Ooh, maybe that's the case. Because, like, so, in my brain, what I was thinking is, like, oh, well, you could move it, like, here and here, and then it's sort of like this. But I don't know if that's possible. Look, Wikipedia, monogenous group. Oh. Different thing. Wait, a cyclic group or monogenous group? I think they're the same thing. It says redirected from monogenous group, from an alternate name. That's the same thing. Yeah, but no. I would just ask him, for a finite cyclic group, we have a Maybe it's just that, like, I think the finite thing is the thing that's different, what you're saying, right? There's the same problem with the definition of a field. If you were to, I think, either like mention it in your paper or just talk with your instructor about it, I feel like you could clear it up, you know? But there's acceleration. Maybe they just mean it's not. Oh my god, wait. Wait a second. No, we are doing. No, we're not doing general plane motion. God damn it. We're not doing general plane motion. Because, like, we had a problem that was like a log. And then, like, it moves. And then, like, if this thing snapped, then that would be general plane motion because it's gonna, like, turn and then move. You know? But, like, we're not doing that yet. So, oh my god. Wait, so it doesn't. So that means that the angular acceleration. There's no angular acceleration. It's just. Oh my god. Okay. So this is zero? That feels wrong. That feels bad. Wait, so do I literally just sum the forces? Wait, no. I have to, like, do a little bit of work. If I do. Moment about A. Alright, let me try that. Moment about A. Equals, so. I should probably also draw this a little differently. This and this is gonna make more sense. Like this, because we can see then, you know, like, if we do a moment about A, only this part of B is gonna act on A. So, okay, for NB, it's gonna be turning it positively, so NB, and then in terms of the angle, we want, if this is our this, we want this one, we want sine 60. Times the distance between them, which is 9 inches, and then mg is negative mg. I guess the moments equal zero then. It's crazy. I can't believe you just do that. Damien, when the problem is simple. No, it can't possibly be. So what, nb equals. No, it equals, wait, no. Wait. This feels like statics. It's not, that feels wrong. Gamers, what are, wait, 16 pounds? Okay, that's fine. I need to change some stuff in terms of units though. So 16 times 0.5 times 9 over 12. There we go. This feels wrong. Let me get the wrong answer real quick. Let me just get the wrong answer and we'll figure it out from there. 8 divided by 9 divided by 12. And this divided by sine 60. 12.32. Would that be force? That's force. Your exercise reminded me bad thoughts of time when I did physics. I like it. It's just like we actually have only done like one of these problems. Actually, I think maybe we did two. One point. Okay, no, that's wrong. Okay. What? I don't know where the forces are canceling out is the issue. I guess I could take the moment about. Oh no, you know why? Because if you take the moment, you gotta take the You gotta do the acceleration as well. Okay, so this just doesn't work. It's not that this is wrong, it's this way doesn't work. Because I missed a part. Like, this is gonna be like times a distance, like MAY. And we don't wanna do that. I need to figure out a way to. Okay. Fighting the moment about G. That's not super useful. It's rid of all the stuff that I need to use. But it would be so beautiful. Well, maybe, okay, maybe it's not that bad. I was lulled into a false sense of security. It hadn't happened for like an hour. God damn it, Pharaoh's curse. The stream is cursed. Why is my dynamics problems never come out right? Okay. You know that there's acceleration. I guess, well, there is gonna be acceleration in the X direction too. Okay, I hear your voice. Sorry. I don't know how to fix that still. I've been trying. It's a constant battle. Okay. Here or here? It's like, see, this is kind of the same issue that like is present in this one, where it's like, I don't know. We have something with like a constant omega, or like omega is zero, so like omega equals zero, because this is not gonna rotate at this moment. But we don't. How do we? Let's see. Omega is zero. And so what we did was we took the moment about O, and we did. We have to actually use the I of it. Why would we do that? That sucks. I guess I could just put center of masses on both of them. Oh, what's the verb? Oh, it's ear. It's here with an H. And then we can do, the reason we take that is because the angular acceleration cancels. We only get the tangential acceleration. And then... second, but... oh, I see. I see. Okay, maybe we can do this. I hear your voice with an H. Yeah. Okay, it's not exactly parallels the thing. So like if we wanted to do, I hear your voice with my ear, it's true. Okay, let's free body diagram first. That's always a good sort of place. We want to find the forces and the links. Yeah, that's probably gonna want a free body diagram then. Ah, okay, I'm not gonna put my axes in just yet, because I don't know where they're gonna be. But so we have a force pushing up here, and we have one pushing up here. I guess it could be at an angle. We'll do this. FC... X... FC1? And then push that, pull that, FCY, FDY, FDX. Get you over here. I'll go to work, have a nice evening, have a nice time at work. Oh, I drew that on the wrong diagram. They're gonna get me. I draw it on the wrong diagram. Okay, so I guess we have at our centroid, which I don't know where. Oh, no. Okay, wait. Can do this. One centroid. Other centroid. I don't know about this. I'm just gonna pretend that they're both like this. Can't do that. Maybe I can. Otherwise this shape like really kind of sucky. Let's pretend it's like that. So we have a M A M E A M E Y. Alright, A Y. M E A E Y. M E A E X. Now, is there like a tangential component to this? Yes. I'm gonna not draw it like this. But see, like, I can't have my... I mean, I guess I can have multiple axes. It's just, like... A, E, normal, and we'll say... Oh, fine, it goes this way. It's dumb, but fine, it's fine. M, E, A, E, tangential. And then we'll save the same one for this one, so... M, A, 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 N. Man! Let's say it goes this way. M A M A A A T. I mean, two I bars mean I bar E alpha and I bar A alpha. Everyone like my great diagrams? Doesn't everybody love them so much? Oh my god. Ah, I see, if we take the point around, like if we take the moment about B, then we can get rid of those normal accelerations. But, if you go about B, then you still have like AT, I guess. Yeah, we'll figure it out. I have not that much confidence in my ability to figure it out. let's see. What do we do? Where should we sum? Let's maybe do a moment. That seems appropriate. I feel like B is kind of cute. Also, I don't know why I said this should be B and this should be C. Sorry, that should be A. We do a moment about B. Equals I bar alpha. We just say I bar A alpha plus I bar E alpha. Which is like I bar A plus I bar E. Now, okay. That's like incorrect though, because we need to know their distance from the centroid. Don't I have to determine the centroid? Oh, man, I don't want to determine the centroid. Unless they have two different alphas, but they don't have two different alphas because they're the same thing. How do we... Wait, let's see, how do we do it when we said the big thing? Where's the chonky boy? Did we talk about this? Yes, we did. Okay. Yeah, okay. It is what I did. So there's two different I bars, but there's the same alpha.
Which, I guess, maybe could make sense, question mark, I don't know.
Just depending on, I guess, because we have more vectors in there.
Okay. So, only take the moments. Ooh, wait, we're winning. We're winning, guys. This is gonna go away. This is good. Okay, FAX. Times 1.0.5 equals. We have. How do I do this? Equals M. M A. A A T. Times. The distance of that centroid. Okay, so the distance of this centroid is, we do know that, this is gonna be 0.25. Okay, that's our one moment, that goes positive, plus the other one that also goes positive, M-E-A-E-T, which is a little different. Okay, it's a 60 degree angle. We said that this is like tangential. Oh god, okay. What part of it do we need? We need the x component, which would be 60 cosine, would cosine 60. I don't trust that at all. This is 30. This is 60. This. Wait, where's my other 60? Oh no. Oh no. Oh, this is 60. Okay, good. Yes, it is 60. Whew. Okay. Dragon box geometry saving my ass. I was pretty, you can slide the angles up. Anyway. So cosine 60 times 0.525? Is this a longer bar? I drew over it. Oh, it's all going to shit, guys. It's all going to shit. No, okay. It's 0.5 meters. Okay. And then plus, I guess, I bar A alpha plus I bar. Yeah. Okay, that's something. That's something that we have now. Okay. All right, we have that. Cool. We need some more stuff because we have nothing. How many unknowns do we have? Let's see. One. Two. Three. Four. That's not good. That's actually bad. Okay. I guess, like, it's not rotating. Wait. It's not rotating. Wait, so this one goes away. Because this is zero. I don't. Okay. This whole like angular acceleration being zero thing is like really throwing me off, because we just did a bunch of stuff where she was like, the angular acceleration is almost never zero, and now it's just like just handed out zeros like candy. Okay. Okay. So now we only have three unknowns. How can we say something about like AAT? Well. Okay. We can say that, okay, wait a second, I'm cooking. The acceleration at B equals, this is gonna be omega squared times a negative omega squared r. That's fine. Because D doesn't have a acceleration because it's pinned, and D doesn't have an angular acceleration because it's pinned. So B is omega that one. The only acceleration of B is like a normal component. Okay. Do I know how fast it's going? Oh no. Because then I was going to say, oh, well, we can say that the acceleration at A equals the acceleration of B plus, you know, the acceleration of A with respect to B. And this can give us, so we know that there's no angular acceleration. We know it's AB plus omega squared. Well, I guess there's no omega either. It's just AB. Well, because like, okay, I'll finally write it out. Plus alpha AB, which is zero. Plus omega AB, which is also zero.
Okay, wait a second. No, but this alpha might not be an alpha. I lied. There might be an alpha.
Times R A is very good. The omega is zero, though, for sure. I don't know anything about the alpha of AB though, because that's what I'm trying to find. Wait, but I just said it didn't rotate. Oh no, it might rotate, guys. It might rotate here. Well, it doesn't rotate in this instant, but it could be rotating. Okay, we have to keep this there. I mean, I guess I can also relay A to C. Oh, wait a second. Yeah, because A equals... is like AC, is AB. Alright, that's DB. Okay. Maybe. I still need to figure out it going down, though. But I need the tangential and the... so the normal, the... oh, I'm not even adding the normals. What the heck?
when it stops, it's going to, we're like going from, okay, wait, so V0 equals 30, I see. 30 feet per second, and then our VF equals 0. We know delta S equals 20 feet. So acceleration equals, what have we got? S equal, we get time, V squared equals 2A delta S. Okay, negative, so negative 900 equals 2 times A times 20. A equals,
let's see, 40, me.
Kind of bad, but that's fine. 22.5. All right, I can take that. Let's check if that's right before I go any further. And it's negative. Yep, okay, 22.5. Cool. So we did that. Good thing we can do simple kinematics still. Now we gotta do some free body diagrams. I guess I'm just gonna do both, like, on the side here. Or we'll do, like, this is back and this is front. So it skids to rest. So this is 0. No. It's not rotating, but the angular acceleration might not be 0. Is that true? Do the forces. The friction force, normal force, wait. Oh, okay, I see. They want us to do it like this. Which is fine. Back, front, friction force back, friction force front. Might be different. Alright, so we got MG. Acting on that. Oh, because this is 5 feet. And this is 7. Even though it doesn't look like it in my picture. Just trust me, trust me. Okay, I want to fire. Ah. I don't know if I have to do, let's see. Okay, so my first instinct was to do some of the forces in Y. Equals 0. Or equals like MAY, which is 0. Which would be MG minus MG. Like that. Which is good. And then I guess we do some of the forces in X. Equals MAX. We don't know what AX is. That'll be friction force B minus friction force F equals MAX. We're gonna assume that the acceleration is probably to the left. Oh, I need to draw my KD. Right, because it's decelerating. But, you know, maybe it won't be that way. Okay, so how do we find stuff? Let's see. Oh, we know the acceleration. Lol. So FFB plus FFF equals 22.5 times mass. Wait, we don't have a mass. Maybe it'll cancel out later. And then I guess we can say, oh, FFB is, this is like mu. They don't tell us that either, so we'll just say mu NB plus mu NF. That one might not cancel out, but we'll figure it out. Okay. Then we've got, what have we got? We can plug this stuff in. Sure, let's do... NF equals MB... Or MG minus MB. Yeah? Minus plus, yep. So we got mu, NB, plus mu, MG minus NB. I don't know if this mu is canceling out though, like... Uh-oh. We take a moment. Oh, whoops. Okay, never mind.
We don't do that.
Okay, so we're not gonna do that. We're gonna keep the f of x though. We take a moment about here. About this back wheel, about b. A moment about b equals I bar alpha. Now let me see. So they're saying that I bar alpha plus M A D. A bar. It's M A D. Wait, they're taking it about... Oh, yeah, they're taking about the back. Oh, I see. This is 4 feet. Okay, so if we take the moment there, we get... The friction force goes away, we get normal force, so that's a positive. 12 NF minus 5 MG. What is that 4 feet for? Oh, the acceleration equals this plus or minus, I guess, m a x. Or they just keep it a bar times 4. Okay, I see. And the I bar is 0. Okay.
Then...
Then we're gonna just... I guess we just solve that. Is that it? Use the equation, do 5 unknowns. And then you use the coefficient of it. Okay. Okay, so the idea is that we have, like, we have to include... So this is our left side of our equation, this is our right side of our equation. So we have to like take the moment about this point on the right and get that. Okay. Yeah, I think that makes sense. Definitely drawing the acceleration diagrams is like a lot more important. Like, I don't know how to describe it. I feel like it's becomes a lot more important because you're not just like, when you're doing non-rotation stuff, you don't have to do moments for your equations. So, or I mean, you might, but like, we didn't really have to, so. Alright, well, I think that's about the time that I have. I am going to stream tomorrow and do more of this, probably, after I do some more tonight. I think I can take a crack at it now. A better crack at it. But I also have other stuff to do, so, you know. But, yeah, I'm not just gonna disappear. I'm gonna do this, and then, you know, we'll do some other stuff too. I have some games that we could play, or other work stuff.
which is fun. But yeah, I'm gonna see you guys later. Bye.